हेलो, आई एम डॉक्टर सौरभ पटवर्धन फ्रॉम नंदादीप आई हॉस्पिटल, नंदादीप फेको ट्रेनिंग एंड पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट इंस्टीट्यूट, सांगली, महाराष्ट्र, इंडिया। आई ऑल्सो हैव अ यूट्यूब चैनल फॉर टीचिंग सर्जिकल वीडियोज। इन दिस वीडियो आई विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट सबलक्सेटेड कैटरेक्ट मैनेजमेंट, द थिंकिंग प्रोसेस बिहाइंड डिफरेंट स्टेप्स दैट वी टेक ड्यूरिंग दिस केस। वेन एवर वी सी सबलक्सेटेड कैटरेक्ट इन अवर क्लिनिक, एवरी सर्जन thinks about how to manage it. And everyone knows that when we manage these difficult cases properly, it gives us excellent gratification. So this is the lens which is attached to sclera by Zunius 360 degree. This is the schematic diagram of the lens. When we have some of the zonules absent or weak, we get subluxated lens. So we have to think whether it is a static zonular weakness or it is a progressive one. So in progressive, like pseudo exfoliation, Marfan's, homocystinemia, what happens is that over a period of time there will be further weakness of the zonules at different segments. Also we have to consider whether it is a diffuse weakness or whether it is a localized weakness. Diffuse like pseudo exfoliation, Marfan's. So depending on whether it is localized or whether it is diffuse, and static or progressive, we have to decide about whether we want to fix the bag or we want to remove the bag and fix the IOL instead. Like in case of diffuse progressive disease, we can just remove the bag and fix the IOL directly to sclera. When the subluxation is 3 to 4 clock hours, CTR or capsular tension ring is enough to manage the case. But when the subluxation is more than that, say 4 to 6 clock hours, then we have to use a scleral fixation device like a Sioni ring where it is attached to the sclera, or other way to do it is putting a CTR and then using a CT segment and attaching the CT segment to the sclera. This is my favorite method. If the subluxation is more than that, say more than 6 clock hours, and the lens is dangling, then along with CTR we have to use either double Sioni ring or 2 CT segments, so that on both sides the lens and bag is attached to the sclera. Another important issue which has to be noted is that whether to use iris retractors or capsular hooks to stabilize the bag. When we use the iris retractors, the main support is given to the anterior capsule, but the posterior capsule remains unsupported, and during the removal of cataract during phaco, this posterior capsule may come into the phaco probe. In case of capsular hooks, because they are longer and they support the equator of the lens, the posterior capsule also is well supported because of its stretch. So a capsular hook is always preferred over the iris retractors for supporting the bag. As far as the steps are concerned, there are 2 schools of thought. The first school of thought is that we should put CTR at the end. So first we do CCC, followed by capsular hook insertion, which supports the subluxated area of the lens. This is followed by phacoemulsification and cortex removal. Now, because we have not put CTR, the cortex removal is quite easy and it is not trapped by capsular hooks. Then we release the capsular hooks one by one, followed by CTR insertion in the bag, and then we implant CT segment to support the rest of the lens and suture it to the sclera. So this is the first school of thought which is there. Now the second school of thought is that we should put CTR in the beginning so that it supports the bag right from the start. But we must note that CTR just redistributes the support and does not actually add support like the capsular hooks. So in case of advanced zonular subluxation, it may not be useful. Also, it is difficult to release the cortex which is trapped under these capsular hooks. And if there is a posterior capsular rupture during the procedure, then the CTR removal is quite difficult. So I usually follow the first school of thought. Now to support or the fix the CT segment or Sioni ring to sclera, I generally use the 90 proline, but there are other methods like using the 80 Gore-Tex suture, also known as PTFE. And also we can use 5-0-proline, which Dr. Canabrava has showed how it can be used to fix the CT segment or Sioni ring to the sclera using the double flange technique. So whatever method you follow, I recommend that you keep doing the same method again and again to you till you master it, and then you can try other methods. These are other devices like Asia Anchor is there. There is Jacob capsule stabilization device. These both are like paper clips which can be used to keep the bag in place, and they support the anterior capsular axis well. So in case of posterior capsular dehiscence also, these devices can be of use if you have them available in the OT. Another important tip that you should know is how to insert a needle while fixing the bag to the sclera. Important thing is to create space between the iris and the bag by using proper OVD, and then you insert the needle first 90 degree till it penetrates the sclera, and then turn it so that it becomes parallel to the iris. This avoids trauma to the iris root. Also, it stays behind the iris. I think this is one of the important tips that you should know. Now let's move on to some surgical cases. So this is a case of traumatic midriasis, almost looking like aniridia. There is subluxation of almost 6 clock hours or more. The important step is to do a good CCC. So you start from the area of good zonular support, and then you move on to the weaker area and try to center it, imagining the final position of the lens. Another important thing is that the CCC should be appropriately away from the area of zonular dehiscence, because if you don't have this much of space, it is difficult to put the capsular hooks to support the lens in this area. So stay away from the area of dehiscence. The hydro dissection has to be very, very careful, gentle, and try to do cortex cleaving hydro dissection, but at the same time see to it that the nucleus does not prolapse out. Now we have to implant or insert the capsular hooks. These are MST capsular hook. You can see they are long and they have a traumatic curved tip at the end, and it supports the bag very well. Now this is a softer cataract, so I am just doing a aspiration of the lens using the IA probe. Once it is done, I'll be inserting CTR, and as it progresses, I am removing the capsular hooks one by one so the CTR doesn't get entangled with the capsular hooks. So once the CTR is in place, that is in the bag, you can see that the subluxation is more than 6 clock hours, and that's why the bag is still not centered. So I'm going to place the IOL first. You can use a single piece or three piece IOL. And if you are using three piece, you can orient the haptics towards the area of subluxation. And now I have inserted a CT segment through the eyelet. I have already passed the 9-0-proline, and this needle, you can see I am using the railroading technique, and I'm putting it in the reverse manner so that the sharp tip of the 9-0-proline needle is away from the bag. Thus the accidental puncture is avoided. Once both the sutures are passed through the sclera under the scleral flap, you have to tie it using 2-1-1-1 configuration, but don't tie it too tight, otherwise the bag will get decentered. So this is the case after doing pupilloplasty. So let's see the second case here. It's a case of Marfan's, and I'm going to show you some difficulties which might be faced. Here you can see that I could achieve only small CCC because of decentration. So after putting the capsular hooks, now I am enlarging the CCC. So here the tip is that initially you can do a smaller CCC, as many times capsular axis is difficult in initial stages. And after putting the capsular hooks, as you push the lens near the center, you can enlarge the axis later. So in this case, as I am releasing the capsular hooks to allow the Sioni ring here to get inserted in the bag. You can see sometimes it may get entangled, so it is very important to keep watch on that. And here the mistake being done is that I am trying to insert the Sioni in the area of zonular dialysis first, so it doesn't have the support of zonules. And now, as you will see, that the Sioni comes out of the bag. So in this case, you should start inserting the Sioni from the area which is well supported by zonules, so that this issue does not arise. Now let's move on to the next case. So I am showing all the steps where things can go wrong. So this is a case of superior, almost 5 to 6 clock hours of subluxation with dense cataract. I want to show here the fluidics which I am using. You can see on the left side that I am just using 50 centimeters of bottle height here. So I am doing everything at low fluidics, which is very important. If you use higher IOP, this fluid is going to go through the area of zonular weakness and cause fluid deviation and more up thrust. So it is important to complete the procedure at very low IOP. There will be some fluctuations in the anterior chamber, so you have to see to it that you are keeping the vacuum just enough to emulsify and aspirate these nuclear pieces. Now at the same time, you have to keep watching the bag, the behavior of the bag. Now you can see here, if you see closely, though I have put capsular hooks at 3 places, you can see on the inferior part, the capsular bag is trying to come into center, thus it can get aspirated by the phacoprobe anytime. So once you notice that, irrespective of how many capsular hooks you have inserted earlier, you should insert one more to support this part of the bag. Otherwise, you might increase the zonular dialysis if your phacoprobe or IA probe catches hold of this loose bag here. And many times it may happen that the zonular dehiscence may increase during the surgery, or you might have underestimated the area of zonular weakness. So like in case of trauma, the zonular weakness might be more than what is visible in the preoperative period. So as you can see here, once I have inserted the extra capsular hook, the bag again becomes very well supported, and near the end I am reducing my vacuum to almost 150 to 200, so that I get a safe removal of the remaining pieces. So I think always use these low parameters for doing phaco, and this particular habit you should have to insert the OVD from the small side port using your non-dominant hand, so that the anterior chamber remains inflated when you are taking out your phaco probe. Now this is a hard subluxated cataract. What I want to showcase here is that once you support the subluxated area well with the capsular hooks, you can tackle any grade of cataract. So that doesn't matter. You can use the standard nucleotomy techniques. Of course, the chops will be better because you are not pushing the bag down. Even if you are doing a sculpt and divide maneuver, you should make sure that you are not pushing the bag down. In this case, I am showing a difficulty in CTR segment insertion. And here the problem what happened is that I am using a Sinsky dialer to put it in, and it slipped because I am using a very tiny dialer. Normally I use a 1 millimeter Sinsky to dial it, but there is no need to worry. What I am doing here is simply circumferentially I am trying to nudge this CTR very gradually. So be patient, don't try to do very harsh maneuvers here. Just be patient and you will find that the CTR will slowly go inside the bag. If you try to do very hasty maneuvers, sometimes you may damage the bag. So as you can see, as I keep rotating it, the eyelet can be seen, and then I rotated it inside the bag. To avoid this complication, you can support the CTR using second instrument in second hand, so that you can nudge it in the bag while inserting, or it is better to use a forceps or a CTR injector. Now this is another issue which might be faced. Here I am going to use a forceps to insert the CTR in the bag. But when you are inserting it with the forceps, what you have to make sure is that you first reach the same level of the back. Now here the mistake is that I am pushing the CTR much anterior to the back, and that's why the CTR jumped out of the back. So that should be avoided. So now I am doing it better by using forceps, and immediately as I go in the anterior chamber, I will first push the CTR down to the level of the bag, and then I will try to insert it in the bag to avoid the CTR jumping out of the bag. So I think this is a very important maneuver. If you have access to CTR injector, I think it might be an easier way to inject CTR. Now let's move on to the next case. This is a case of post-traumatic subluxation, and in the inferior part you can see there is also traumatic mydriasis. So there is atrophic iris there, and here the plan is to first fix the bag and then do the pupil repair as well. So I am trying to insert this 26 gauge needle so that I can railroad the proline suture, and the difficulty I am facing here is that the needle is going into the iris, and that area the visibility is less. So now I'll be putting some viscoelastic and also trying to judge the level of the needle, whether it is anterior or posterior to the iris, that we have to judge, and then we have to insert the needle further. So remember the tips which I have mentioned earlier: push OVD to make some space between the bag and the iris, and second important thing, make sure that the needle is not coming anterior to the iris, and particularly in these cases where the iris is atrophic, you may miss and push the needle anterior to the iris. So I'm using the Sinsky to check that it comes under the iris here. So it comes under the iris, and then I push the needle through it. So this is the second pass with the needle, and here as you can see there is bleeding, and I cannot clearly see that. I can see the tip, but I don't know whether it has come from the anterior to the iris root or posterior. Still, I went ahead and fixed the bag using the CT segment here, and after that I have implanted the IOL, and then when I started doing pupilloplasty, I realized that in fact the second suture had passed over the iris. So as you can see, the iris is being dragged towards the area where I have inserted the CT segment. So if you are careful, this complication can be avoided. Now what to do if you have a non-dilating pupil with weak zonules? I think the iris retractors are the best device to use it in such cases, because you can assess the zonular area really well, because you can enlarge the pupil size to desired using the iris retractors. Some surgeons use capsular hooks to dilate the pupil, and then they insert the same capsular hooks into the bag once you have done the CCC. Also, that is another way of doing it. But here I am inserting the iris hooks first, and then I am inserting the capsular hooks later. So both ways you can manage a case of a small pupil with a zonular weakness. Now the next case is a case with subluxated cataract with fibrose anterior capsule. So this is a post-traumatic subluxation with mature cataract, and you can see the folds or the anterior capsule, it is fibrose. So once I started doing the capsular excis, what I noticed is that it ran into the area of fibrose capsule. So I tried to push it further, but once it goes into that area of fibrosis, I have to cut this area. So I'm using a 26 gauge needle. You can also use the scissors to cut it. And then assisted by 26 gauge, I am completing the capsular excis, and I could do it. Now the area from where I have cut the capsular excis, we do not know whether that area is strong enough to withstand the stretching which happens during phacoemulsification. So after putting the capsular hooks, I decided that I will do a small incision cataract surgery in this particular case. So I made the scleral tunnel with small incision cataract surgery. We are not raising the pressure in the anterior chamber as much as we do it in phacoemulsification. Also, we don't need frequent handling of the nucleus or nuclear rotations as in phaco. And also, as the fluid going in is less, there is less chance of fluid deviation and the vitreous being pushed up. So if you are not sure of your capsulorhexis, you can always use small incision cataract surgery to remove the nucleus. It is better to use a larger tunnel so that during nucleus delivery, there is no resistance which is felt. The capsular hooks help here also because they are supporting the bag so that during nucleus delivery, the bag will not come out. So I am using a Sinsky to dial this nucleus out. Luckily, the CCC size is good enough so that I can take out the nucleus in the anterior chamber easily. And then I am visco expressing the nucleus from the bag, making sure that bag doesn't collapse too much during the maneuver. I will do dry aspiration of the cortex here, just under the viscoelastic. And now you can see the insertion of the CTR. Here I am using a second instrument to support the CTR so that it goes into the bag. Now here I am not sure of the capsulorhexis. So in case I insert the CTR, it tears apart the capsulorhexis or the bag, I may lose the CTR into vitreous. So what I have done here is I have threaded one of the eyelets using the 10-0 nylon suture here. Now you can see under careful visualization, I am inserting the CTR. You can see that the CTR has gone properly inside the bag, and that area from where I had cut the capsulorhexis was not torn. So now I know that now CTR is supporting the bag well, and now I can release this suture and take out this suture. So this suture really helps in case there is a posterior capsular rupture or opening which happens during CTR insertion. So you can always pull this CTR end out and you can take out the CTR. Thank you so much for your kind attention.